there everyone, I hope you are having a great day. Today I would like to talk to you about eyebrows. Well, my experience with eyebrows started around when I was 12 years old and I noticed how thick my eyebrows were then. I was like no one in my family, my parents were nothing like me. I had very, very thick eyebrows, almost like a unibrow, and I had also a little moustache growing. So, of course, I started using tweezers as soon as my facial hair started growing, and by the age of 14, reading all kind of books, I noticed, well, I came across this face yoga exercises, and I noticed that I can organize my eyebrows to look much better than they did, thing which I do until now. So for this I started doing these facial exercises by raising the eyebrows and using my fingers to bring them down, and this force not only works on the eyebrows but also on the muscles, so you have strong muscles for the rest of your life if you do these exercises several times per week for say 5-10 minutes, building up throughout the years. The next exercise is also frowning, doing the same kind of action. So there you have it, you have got very strong muscles, forehead muscles, and also you work on your eyebrows. The next thing I did was using the scissors and the tweezers, as I mentioned to you. And scissors, why? Because I was bullied. I was bullied for having thick eyebrows. And even now my eyebrows are thick. They don't look as thick in this light because light is so strong. So it shows all the negative things about my eyebrows. They are not perfect. But as I said, I was bullied and one person said, oh, why don't you cut the eyebrows? So I started cutting the eyebrows just the way I do now. Another person said, oh, why do you cut your eyebrows? So conclusion is you can never make people around you happy. So this is one of those things that I started doing when I was in my teens and I do until now. Scissors and tweezers are always close to me besides doing these facial exercises. And the next step is brushing the eyebrows. Even a simple pencil like this NYX pencil, which is designed to fill in the gaps between the missing hair pieces, it does wonders with your eyebrows. So you can use your fingers to make sure the eyebrows grow into a certain direction, and trust me, after maybe 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, if you have got stubborn hairs like mine, they're going to start growing in a certain directions. But you always need a little brush in order to make sure that your eyebrows are perfect, and then you fill in the gaps with this little pencil, which I like so much. I'm not very keen on painting my eyebrows, but in this video I'm going to discuss even about this, about painting the eyebrows with pigment and gels. And as I said, I have got very thick eyebrows until now, unlike no one in my family. And yes, the light here is not helping. My eyebrows appear thinner and not so many. You can count almost the pieces of hair there, which is not fair onto me, but there you have it. It's much better to start with the imperfection than showing a perfect video of a person who has perfect eyebrows and is like 15 years old. So here I'm showing how to paint the eyebrows with the pigment, and I'm using here the collection pigment, which I purchased some time ago. You can also use Anastasia Beverly Hills or other gels, which I'm showing you here, but I'm not very keen on them because they are very strong. And the method that works for me is to paint from the lower side towards upper, but never put much pigment on above the brow. And you can see lots of videos out there, people caking their eyebrows in all this pigment or gels. Bottom line is, since this was not done, say, 20 years ago or 10 years ago, the way it is not done nowadays, you might lose the pieces of hair. So you might, in some 10 years time, you might discover that, hey, you know, now I'm 30 years old, I hardly have any pieces of hair. Just like with primers, lots of primers leave you with spots underneath the skin or even foundation. And lots of people don't talk about this, which is not good. So this is my method, which I don't do all the time because I would look very, very masculine. So I don't like that. In this camera, under this light, it looks okay, but I'm very, very doing it very delicately during the day because I don't want to create this manly expression or caked in makeup expression or fake expression. I'm not keen on that. So this is my method of drawing the eyebrows, and underneath, if you want, you can use some clear mascara to make sure the eyebrows are staying in that place you want, and you can also create the contrast. And for this contrast, you can use different type of foundations, light foundation, just draw a line there, as I noticed lots of girls seem to be doing that, or a pencil the way you see here. So this is one of my tricks. I apply and I wipe it, apply and wipe it to make sure it's very natural and looks flawless. This is something that works perfectly for me. For you might not work. For somebody who is 15 or 20 years old might work perfectly to, as I said, to put everything everywhere, but not to me. So you have to adjust your makeup according to every single age, as we all age differently, and very few people look when they're older as when they were 20 years old and still be recognizable. So, well, there you have it. I hope all this information was of any help to you, that you learned some things here, and keep in touch with me. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.